Hi there, this video comes with some exercise files and a cheat sheet for Photoshop. There'll be a link in the description for those. Okay, it's part of my larger course, which you can go and check out. There'll be a link there as well. All right, enjoy the video. Hi there, in this video, we're going to dive into blending modes a little bit more. Basically, it's how a layer interacts with the background. This particular use case is really great when you've got an image, like this hand drawing I've done, all this logo and it's kind of stuck to the white background. Watch this, ready, city, just magically disappears the background. It takes one click to do it. Same thing when we've got that same logo, it was black, now it's white on a dark background. They're called blending modes. They can really save you some time. Let's get into them now. All right, to get started, let's go to File. Let's go to Open. We're in a new folder now called 10 Blending Modes. Open up Blending 1, 2, 3, and 4. We're gonna start with 1 and 2. So we've looked at blending modes before in this course and we just kind of ignored them really. I just told you to do them and they did some magic. Now it's time to understand them a little bit more. And one of the kind of main uses for it when you wanna remove the white background of something. So in this case, I've got this logo here. It is not on its own layer. It is smushed into the white background here and I wanna remove the white. So what I do is with my move tool selection, click, hold, drag onto blending mode 1, let go. Now, before we move on, this works amazingly for black onto a light background. If you need it to be white on a dark background, we'll do it in a sec. It's not as good, just so you know. But in this case, it's pretty magic. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get it down here, gonna resize it a little bit so it fits. But before I do that, I'm gonna convert it into a smart object because that's what we're doing, right? We're doing everything pro now. Convert to smart object. Now I'm gonna shrink it down so that quality is still there. Hit return. So I've got the logo, but it's got this dreaded white border around it. All we're gonna do is with this top layer selected, I'm gonna change it from normal, and this one here is gonna be the magic one, multiply. Cool, huh? Now we did it with a logo. Let's say we've done it with this hand drawing. We're looking at blending 04. So I'm gonna click, hold, drag with my move tool, drag, let go. Same thing, it's a bit big. I drew this in my notebook, I've scanned it in, and I wanna see if I can lay it out, but it has the white background. So instead of doing a mask, which can be tough, we're gonna convert it to a smart object, which is not particularly necessary other than we wanna keep all that good quality in there. Okay, and I'm gonna drag it. And because it needs to go onto a white background, it's gonna work perfect. Well, I've made a lightish background so you can see it a little nicer. So you can kind of see it through. So I've got my little drawing here and I'm gonna change that from normal to multiply. Cool, huh? So dark on light is perfect. You can move it around, okay, and you can see it. Now there's lots of things you can't do to it. It's quite a really specific use. You need to just chop out the white background. If I'm gonna try and color this with say a color overlay, it's just not going to work, watch. Da! So if you wanna get into kind of recoloring it, you're gonna have to look at masking out the black or maybe vectorizing it in something like Illustrator. There's something called Live Trace, which can really save the day. But if you've got a logo and you've copied it off somebody's website and you need to use it and you need to chop out the white background, good to go. Now there is a case where you want it on a dark background. Okay, so the black's not gonna work. So I'm gonna do the same thing, blending 02, grab them. Okay, we've got them here, convert them to a smart object. I'm skipping that step because I'm going fast. Okay, and you'll notice that multiply works, but just not the way I want it. I want it to be white. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna work your way through these blending modes and you'll eventually get to, where is he? Divide. Okay, and it's gonna kinda work. It's working good because it's kind of monochromatic in the background. There's no real color going on. Watch what happens when it goes over color. So really, that's a kind of a small use case where it's monochromatic in the background, you need it to be white. I show you this because surprisingly enough, I use it enough when I'm doing kind of design work and you just can't find the logo off someone. Now, if you are doing this type of layout in something like InDesign or Illustrator instead of Photoshop, you will be able to find blending modes in all of those programs as well. You can check out my courses on both those bits of software. I cover it in those too. All right, so getting into blending modes, we've covered it a little bit. This one particular cool little usage, great when you've got a logo or a drawing and you need to remove the background. All right, next video.
Hi, it's me again. If you enjoyed the video, a thumbs up really helps me in what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to my YouTube channel because I release a video like this every week. Also know that this is part of my larger course. Okay, so this is like a free part of it. There's a larger course called Photoshop Essentials. So you could go check that out. There's a link in the description for that full course. Also know that there's exercise files. Those are free to download. Go go check that out. Link in the description. Another link in the description will be the cheat sheet. So I make it like a PDF cheat sheet for Photoshop with all the tips and tricks you can print off and stick next to your computer and be more awesome. Link in the description. Yeah. All right. That's enough. Hi, Data.